The future is bright indeed. We're all of us dreaming of the better days ahead, and a part of your bright new future could be a move to where the magic lives in the greater Orlando area of Florida. One of the biggest decisions you'll make when considering a move is selecting a realtor who can successfully match you with the right home in the right location at the right price. Victor Naraki is the realtor who can help you make the move you've always wanted to. Whether you're a first-time homeowner or looking to move near Disney World, Victor is in your corner. If you are looking for an experienced real estate agent covering all of Central Florida, please visit DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com today and find out just why you should work with Victor. I encourage you to create a free, no-obligation account on his website. By doing so, you'll unlock the website's full potential and be able to enter specific criteria, save listings, and browse new properties sent to your email. Visit DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com today or visit his Facebook page, Victor Naraki Realtor. And don't forget to tell him the Grand Circle Tour podcast sent you.
Feel the heart of Africa the moment you walk through the door, where the tastes, sounds, and sights of the savanna immerse you in a whole new world of relaxation. Teeming with exotic wildlife, the spirit of African adventure invigorates every aspect of Disney's Animal Kingdom Lodge. Located in Disney's Animal Kingdom Resort area, Disney's Animal Kingdom Lodge is a deluxe resort.
When the guests get inside the lobby the first time, they will see our costume, they will hear our accents. Immediately, they feel the spirit of Africa.
Thatched roofs, intricate carvings, and magnificent African art take you to a place unlike anything you've seen.
Back in Africa, when we built our houses in the villages, we built them in a circular formation to keep our animals between the buildings.
That same design is used here to give guests one-of-a-kind views of four separate savannas, alive with more than 200 animals.
We have zebras, we have giraffes, we have kudu, we have ostriches. When I'm here, I feel like I'm in a real village in Africa.
And if that doesn't bring you close enough to the animals, give this a try. Safari vehicles take you right up to the African wildlife for an up-close and personal experience you'll never forget. Complete with a one-of-a-kind view. Ready for a swim? Taking a dip in a free-form pool provides a fun splash to your day, perfect for playing and relaxing. These pools are practically overflowing with surprises. When it's time to dine, appetites are satisfied at one of 8 African-inspired dining locations, including Jiko, the cooking place, a fine dining restaurant with a delicious blend of traditional African, Indian, and Mediterranean cuisine. Found throughout this resort is a richness of Africa that even extends to your room. Relax in handcrafted furnishings, authentic African decor, and kente fabrics. Many rooms offer breathtaking balcony views of the reserve and the animals. This is your outpost for adventure, where the excitement and natural wonders of the savannah beckon as your family heads into the heart of an African wonderland at Disney's Animal Kingdom Lodge.
Jumbo passengers, and welcome to the next Disney Resort detour on our schedule. We are here today to feature Animal Kingdom Lodge with history, fun facts, figures, room information, activities, you name it, and oh, food. Can't forget that. With me are my two favorite co-hosts and a special guest. And she has stayed at this resort many times and knows it very well. Now, we're going to introduce Mary Wells first. So, Mary, welcome to this detour, and thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me. I'm looking forward to telling you a little bit about the Animal Kingdom Lodge.
Good. And also with me today are my two favoritest co-hosts, Ringmaster Holly and Skipper Jay. How are you guys? And are you excited to talk about this resort?
Aloha. It's Monday. So I hope this brings the Monday up, because it is a Monday.
And Chris, you actually introduced Mary wrong. She is queen head of the GCT. She signs all my paychecks.
Our manager, HR.
I had to put that title
up. And head of HR.
Yeah.
Jay's working on his raise.
Yeah, that big whooping raise.
Whooping.
So this week, while I've been working on my research and making my notes, I have been listening to the Animal Kingdom Lodge loop music while I made my notes, and it was so calming listening to that while I was trying to concentrate on everything that I was reading and writing down. And you know, that resort is, to me, I've only been there a couple times, but it is like very calming. So before we get started talking about this resort, we are going to hear from our sponsor, MEI Mouse Fan Travel, and they can help you book a stay at this resort. Let's go, Ken.
I'm Ken, the voiceover guy, and I'm here with Lori Oliveri from MEI Mouse Fan Travel. Lori, do you only book trips to Walt Disney World?
No, I can book trips all over the world, wherever you want. Royal Caribbean Cruise Lines, Princess Cruise Lines, Viking Voyages, Ama Waterways, Avalon. I can book you Universal trips. They're building a brand new park, also Universal is.
If you would like more information on booking your dream vacation, visit their website at meitravel.com. And don't forget to tell them the Grand Circle Tour podcast sent you.
And we are back. So Animal Kingdom Lodge is an African-themed deluxe resort that was designed by Peter Dominic of Urban Designs Group in Denver, Colorado. And this resort, like others designed by the same architect, include Disney's Wilderness Lodge and also Disney's Grand Californian Hotel and Spa at Disneyland. So let's get into talking about some details about this particular location. Jay, what kind of property does this sit on, and what's its general location?
Oh, huge. This is, it's a 46-acre property, and it sits at the very, very south end of property. You can actually see it as you're driving and I drive.
Mm-hmm.
International Drive, I mean. Correct myself. You can see the back of Animal Kingdom too. You can see the back of Blizzard Beach from back there. But it is huge. 33 acres of those 46 acres are all the savannah.
Mm-hmm.
So we have
that is a lot.
It's huge. It is, and the great thing about it, once you get there, you do feel like you're transported to Africa because you're so remote. It's so big and it's so detailed.
Yeah. So does this, Mary, if I'm wrong, correct me, but does this sit on about 75 acres total?
It is a big resort. I know sometimes people like to complain about the long hallways.
Yeah. Now, from what I read, it does sit next to a 400-acre wetland. So none of that can be developed, which is really nice because the whole area is then protected.
Develop yet.
Yeah. Well, if it's a designated wetland, they're not going to be able to. So planning period for this was 1997 to 98. And initial construction started in 98 and took 2.5 years to complete. And it had an opening date of April 16th of 2001. So, Holly, what can you tell us about the design of this resort?
So, the design team, they wanted the guests to experience a journey, like they were actually on, like something they would see if they were on a safari trip. So, like authentic experiences, the textiles, the art, the artifacts. Like if you were actually going to Africa, and you can clearly see that. And I remember a long time ago when we had Mary on our live show, she actually gave us a tour on the live show and went through and showed us a lot of those artifacts and the textiles hanging on the wall And I mean, we really wouldn't expect anything less from a Disney property. And that's how we're able to go into all of these detours, because there is so much history on all of these resorts. Mm-hmm. They're not just hotels, you know, they have these stories. And then, like you said, the wetlands, I think that just adds to the whole feeling of actually being in Africa on a safari, and now you're protected because you're not seeing another building right next to it. Right. So I think that, so I don't know if they planned that purposely as well, but I wouldn't put it past them.
Yeah. Yeah. Mary, do you have any input on history or anything we might have missed as far as design goes?
Well, the only other thing is that when it originally opened, the main building, which is Jumbo, wasn't DVC.
Right.
They added that part later with Kidani.
Right.
So, you know, when I looked up some things, you got kind of different numbers of rooms going on for how many rooms were in, in Jumbo. And that's because they took some of them and made them into DVC villas, and they can count them different depending on how, you know, if you're getting a studio one bedroom, and then if you get a two bedroom, you might get a studio with a one bedroom lock off. And and then there's a select number of, there's only 15. So there's five studio, five one bedroom, and five two bedroom that are on the concierge level. So they're either on level five or six, and they're really hard to book, but you get to use the, you know, the concierge lounge, which is.
Now, is that, as far, you said hard to book, is that for DVC or is that for anybody?
Those are just for DVC. I mean, anybody can book the DVC rooms, but not the concierge rooms.
Oh, okay.
You can pay for concierge rooms.
I did not know that.
That's plenty of them, but yeah. So it's a nice perk, even though they're hard to book.
Do you want to talk about the any of the different types of rooms that they have there?
So it's kind of unique in that in Jumbo, they have, you know, the standard rooms for everybody, and then there are different kinds there. You know, they have the pool view and the, I guess the standard view, which could be like a parking lot or something.
Yeah.
And then the Savannah view. And then
but it's a Savannah parking lot.
Yes.
It's painted green.
It's exotic.
Exotic, yes.
Which I actually, I have to say, I'm a little bit cheap with my points. So I actually don't usually book a Savannah view. Okay. I actually always ask to be near the front of the resort so I can see the bus loop.
Okay.
You're near the front then, which is really the perk that we're talking about.
Right.
And then you just go down a little ways and you can look out a window and see some animals. But I have not, I have stayed in a standard room that's not DVC a long time ago, but I guess this is one of the properties where you can get like two queen beds, a king bed, and you can also get bunk beds with your queen bed. So that's good if you got a couple kids.
Okay.
But then the cool thing about Jumbo is, and again, they're kind of hard to book with your points, is there's something called value studios and one bedrooms and two bedrooms. Mm-hmm. So they're a little smaller. We actually stayed in one once. They're kind of hard to book because they're even less points, which Animal Kingdom points in terms of DVC are kind of low anyway.
Yeah, that they are. That's because I was thinking about renting DVC points once, and I was thinking about staying there. And I was actually very surprised at how little points I would have needed to do that.
Why do you think that is?
There's a lot of rooms. And I mean, the dues are higher, not as high as some of the other ones. The dues are actually worse other places, but there's just a lot of rooms. But and some people don't like it because of, you know, it is a little bit further away. You know, most deluxe resorts, you're walking to a park and you're going to take the bus to Animal Kingdom.
Yeah.
But it's like 5 minutes. It's not bad.
Yeah.
So, I mean,
you know. All right. So, Jay, since we're talking about transportation, let's hear what they have available for transportation at this resort.
Are you ready for my big, long, complicated answer?
Yes, I am so ready.
Bus. That's your transportation, the bus. Unless you want to drive or take an Uber / Lyft, bus. That's your only option.
Okay. So do you have kind of average times to get to the different parks from this resort?
I want to say yes, but it changes so frequently. When I looked at it today, it's It just depends on what time of day, what time of season you're at. It could be 15 minutes. It can run every 15 minutes. It can run every 20 minutes. Or it could be an hour. It's sometimes over an hour. It just depends on what day of the year, what time of year you are.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Bus. All That's right. my answer. Bus.
So I guess that might be another reason that it's not as expensive because of that. Right there, because you can only take the bus.
Right. I mean, if you have a car and you're staying, especially at Kidani, it's nice because there's parking right underneath. And once you figure out how the layout is, you can really park like literally right under your room and then take the elevator up. I mean, it's that's pretty nice.
Well, I was going to say this before we get to the proximity, but it's actually pretty cheap to take an Uber anywhere on property from there because your furthest distance, Magic Kingdom, is only 9 miles. Mm-hmm. So that's going to cost you about $15 plus tip if you don't want to wait for bus.
It's really like 20 minutes to Magic Kingdom. It's not that bad. You know, we don't go in the most peak times and stay there, but when we go, we do use the bus and it's fine. It's not terrible.
Well, that's good to know.
I mean, this episode's coming out Friday, the height of spring break. So bus may not be your answer, but...
But on an average, though.
Okay.
So before we get into the rest of the information, I feel the need to talk about the wide variety of dining options that are at this resort. And Mary, I'm going to ask you as we go through the different locations, if you've dined there and what are your thoughts? Okay.
Okay, I think I got them all covered.
So first off, we're going to start out with the Mara, which is named for a river following through Kenya and Tanzania. And it's a savanna-like space that serves classic entrees and grab-and-go favorites. So it's your basic quick-serve location for this resort. The hours are 6:30 in the morning to 11 p.m., and before I get into anything about pricing, I'm going to throw in our normal disclaimer that says at the time of recording. So if they change prices in 2 weeks from now, not my fault.
If you're listening in 2027, you do not get to get mad at us. It'll be double whatever it is in 2024.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay, so this location has snacks, normal food court style food available, beverages, and they also have different beers. They have bottles of South African wines, some cocktails, breakfast, lunch, and dinner foods are available, desserts and bakery items as well, such as the ever popular Zebra Domes. Now, the entrees at this location, it says $14.99 and under. Now, there's a couple things here and there. There are a little bit more, but that $14.99 is like an average price. So they have this thing called a Kilimanjaro bowl, which has a mountain of potato barrels, aka tots, topped with scrambled eggs, sausage, gravy, cheddar cheese, bacon, and chives for around $11. So that's not too bad because that sounds like it's a lot of food. Mary, have you had breakfast here?
No. Breakfast? Not, Mary doesn't know what breakfast is. Yeah,
I was going to say.
Mary doesn't know what breakfast is.
You said they're open till 11, but they cut off the kitchen at 10. So you're stuck with like grab and go at 10 p.m. Yeah.
Lunch has a little higher prices here and there. They have a combination bowl for $15.79 that contains shrimp, oat grilled chicken, rice, kale slaw, cucumber, tomato salad. And that one is almost $16. They have a tamarind barbecue pork sandwich for $11.29. They have flatbreads. They have cold sandwiches, salad.
Did I mention I didn't eat today?
Now I'm making you hungry. I'm good. And they do have a lot of plant-based items on this menu. And matter of fact, there's a lot of restaurants at this location that have a lot of plant-based food
items. I'm not vegan, but I've been trying some of Disney's plant-based options, and they are very tasty. I'm kind of ready to go to AK just to try out some of those plant-based foods.
Yeah. So have you been there for lunch or dinner?
Yes, many times.
And what's your general thought on the food?
I actually like something that's going to sound kind of crazy. In the cold thing, it's that ham and cheddar sandwich that's on the menu, which sounds really boring, but it's on that sunflower multigrain bread, and that bread is really good. I will say, I mean, there's not as many choices on this quick serve place as some of, you know, other places, I would say. Mm-hmm. So, like, if you're staying here for a week, I will say I kind of get sick of eating here because it's, you know, there's not a whole lot of variety. But you kind of knew that going into Animal Kingdom Lodge. You're a little limited on dining, which is probably another reason why some people shy away from it. But, I mean, I've tried most things on the menu that aren't breakfast items, and they're all good. Okay. They had a flatbread I really liked, and they don't have it anymore. I'm hoping maybe they'll bring it back. It was like a barbecue chicken flatbread. It was really good. So maybe they'll bring that back. But you could just go to Sanaa and get the bread service at like 10:45, and that's good since they don't give
you anything. Poor Holly. I can see you dying of hunger.
Yeah.
Literally,
I haven't even started yet, and she's already dying. Okay, so next we have the pool bars, and the one is, I hope I'm pronouncing this right, Maja Pool. Am I saying that right?
I think sure.
Okay, and the Uzima Springs Pool. Yep. Now, the Maja is, it's Swahili for water. That's what that means. And the pool bar offers sandwiches, salads, and select snacks, along with cocktails, wine, draft beers. And of course, guests need to be 21 and over to consume alcohol. Some of the food options at Maja are an all-beef foot-long hot dog with chili and cheese for $14.79, multi-grain grilled vegetables, citrus dressing for $11.49, which that one sounds really good. And short ribs, short rib grilled cheese for $12.99. And that sounds really sounds yummy.
Good. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Have you ever had that, Mary?
Yeah, that is actually very good.
Okay. All right. The other pool bar, the Uzima Springs, features non-alcoholic beverages, beers, drinks on the rocks, such as the Sunshine Margarita for $17. They have frozen drinks like pina colada for $16. They have wines and sangrias. And you can ask the bartender about daily African wine selections and some specialty cocktails. Here you can invigorate your senses at this spring of life during the hours of 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. Mary, do you ever go to the pool bars?
Not so much. I'm not much of a drinker. So, and usually we go there in January, and it's usually kind of chilly.
Kind of cold.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So next we have the Cape Town Lounge and Wine Bar. And this lounge is located near Jiko, the cooking place. Enjoy an appetizer and wine pairing prior to a meal at Jiko. A full bar is also available here, and the hours are 5 to 9:30 p.m. Next, we find ourselves at Victoria Falls Lounge, and here you can find a full service bar along with suds, beer from South Africa before or after dinner inside this intimate setting overlooking Boma Restaurant. A host of South African wines are also featured, and all of which can be enjoyed in the flickering ambiance of the fire pit that's outside.
Kris, have you ever had any of the wines from there? I know Mary hasn't. Kris, have you?
Me? Yeah. I have not had any alcohol at Animal Kingdom
because
Lodge.
What? I heard that the wineries in South Africa are supposed to be really fantastic. So I'm wondering if the wine, you know, because sometimes you can have a good winery, but not wine, you know what I mean? So I wonder how the wine is, and that's really
cool. I have not. I think that I had and I want to say that it was red, a South African wine at California Grill.
Oh, okay.
The last time I was so, there.
You know what? It's only 20 minutes away. Why don't you guys talk amongst yourselves for about 90 minutes? I'll be right back. I'm going to go try a wine flight. And
let us know. Yeah.
I'll pick up the recording there.
Now, the
lounge, I went to some nice wineries, but the wine is not good. And I know that doesn't make any sense, but it's beautiful. And, you know, they maybe have good snacks or whatever, but the wine is terrible.
I mean, so. I from what I understand, South African wines are actually very good. There's a lot of them that win awards year after year after year. So that lounge is the food that they offer there. From 5 to 10 p.m., but they stop cooking at 9, rotates by season. So you need to check with the server to see what is actually available. Specialty cocktails such as the Baobab 75. This features an African rosé gin, Graham Beck Brut rosé wine, lemon juice and pure cane syrup for $17. That sounds so good.
Yeah, that's interesting.
I need one of those right now.
I'll be right back.
Okay. Wine flights are also available at this location. So there you go. Just head over to the Victoria Falls Lounge, Jay, and bring back that wine flight.
I'm just going to pop down and just pick up the recording from Victoria Falls.
Okay.
Grab me a Zebra Dome while you're there.
Yeah, there you go. So next, we are stopping at the lounge at Sana'a, which is located in the villas at Kidani Village. The hours there are 11:30 a.m. to 9:30 p.m. Savor, again, unique African wines and specialty drinks at this inviting lounge inspired by a spice market of Africa. Snack on Indian-influenced appetizers with your cocktail and then venture outside to see the exotic animals roam around the savannah. As mentioned, here you can savor appetizers, cocktails such as indigo hibiscus, featuring Empress 1908 Gin, Bowles Blue Curacao liqueur. You know I had to stick one of those in here. Lemonade and almond. That one sounds really good too. So beers and ciders, hard ciders are also available there. Since we are just at the lounge at Sana'a, we're going to head over to the actual restaurant. And they have two distinct dining experiences at this location. They have the, I hope I'm going to pronounce this right, Kamsha, is that how you pronounce it? Breakfast?
Sure.
You know, Mary?
Again, this is breakfast. breakfast.
It's a casual quick service offering that does not require reservations. And it's a table experience for lunch and dinner featuring African cooking with Indian flavors. So have you eaten lunch or dinner here?
Yes. Now, see, when they opened, they didn't have breakfast. And they added that because... that's really when you're in that building. So that's, you know, the DVC building with the lots of rooms, lots and lots of rooms.
Yep.
There's no breakfast and there's no quick serve. Mm-hmm. So, you know, people wanting to grab breakfast and go to the park needed an option. So they added that breakfast. But
really, it's a great idea because it's a convenient location for people staying in that section. So.
Yes. And I mean, you know, a lot of people that are DVC are staying there. You know, you do have, even in the studio, you have a mini fridge and like you get a toaster and a microwave. So, you know, a lot of folks bring food or order groceries or whatever. So, but they did add that. So that I just have I don't get up that early.
Okay. But. So hours for lunch are 11:30 to 3 with price ranges that basically match the dinner pricing and the dinner hour is 5 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. and they range from $15 to $35 according to the Disney website.
Yes. I mean, I feel like this is one place that still and I'm just checking the dinner menu real quick, that is one of those places that is still a little bit different for lunch and dinner, whereas a lot of other restaurants, it's the same really menu for lunch and dinner. So I feel like you can go here and have a pretty reasonably priced lunch too, because, you know, if you get that bread service, which I'm sure most of everybody listens to this knows what the bread service is, you know, you get the nine sauces and then the non bread, you know, you eat that and you get pretty full. So you don't really need, you know, two entrees. You could share an entree. So, and then they do have, you know, nice desserts that are smaller desserts. So you're not talking about huge things, which is nice.
Good. Okay, so similar appetizers for lunch and dinner with a few differences. I am not a lover of Indian food. So I would not myself, I would not eat at this place. I'm sorry.
There's a burger on the lunch menu and it's perfectly fine.
That's good. So yeah, no, I'm not, I don't like hummus. I don't like the bread service, totally turns me off. All those spices that are in all those sauces.
Well, you can get, not, I mean, there are non-spicy ones. Some of them aren't too spicy. If you start at the one end.
I like non-bread though.
I mean, so what else besides the bread service, what do you order that you love, Mary?
Well, like a lot of times, literally, I'll get the burger at lunchtime because it's good. And then there's a chicken meal. It's like chicken on naan and it has like mayo and tomato. I mean, it's not anything real. Like I don't go for the real, you know, out there things.
Yes,
and yeah, those are kind of basic and they're very good. Mm-hmm. And then the desserts are good, too.
Mm-hmm. Now they have kids meals are available for under $15. A lot of allergy friendly items. The menu is extensive with allergy friendly items. So that's awesome because, you know, and Disney has been getting better and better and better as the years have gone by about featuring allergy friendly.
You know, because I'm jump in for a second because I'm someone with a lot of food allergies. It's very restrictive for me to go out sometimes. Disney is amazing with food allergies. I just made a reservation for Oka's 2 weeks from today and they were like, we need to know right now, do you have any allergies? List them please. And when you do have an allergy, your food is prepared separately and it comes with a little stick that says allergy.
So it can take a little while longer because the last time we ate lunch there, my friend was with us. And she has quite a few different allergies and they came out and checked with her. And then it did take a little longer, but I mean, we were fine.
Yeah. I mean, when I was looking on the website, I was scrolling and scrolling and scrolling.
Oh,
and there was way more allergy friendly items than there was regular food. So that's amazing. All right. So next we're going to head back over to the lodge for Boma Flavors of Africa. Now this resembles living in an African marketplace and offering all you can eat buffet for breakfast with hours of 7:30 to 11:30. And the cost is pretty up there, $35 to $59 per adult. And then dinner is 5 p.m. to 9:30 p.m.
Is that character?
No.
Wow.
No.
But I'm going to shock you and tell you that I actually have been to this breakfast and it's my favorite breakfast on property that's not character.
Really?
I just fell off my chair.
You said till 11:30 a.m.
Well, you know, it's funny because I hear that price and I hear all you can eat and I think all you can eat is a challenge at that price. Bring it on.
Exactly.
I mean, if you're really like going to go and chow down, $60, I guess, isn't really that bad.
Okay. And let me just say, you know, don't go do this like at 7 a.m. and then try to rush to like Magic Kingdom and ride 18 Rock. Like, no.
Right.
Like, I make this at like 10:55 and then it's like lunch, breakfast, lunch. And you stay there and, you know, hang out.
You're brunching, Mary. You're brunching.
Exactly.
And you can't rush to Magic Kingdom because bus.
Right. Yes. So foods listed on the breakfast menu range from omelets to carved ham, waffles, cinnamon rolls, to deviled eggs with smoked salmon. Again, they have a lot of allergy-friendly options, so all you have to do is ask about that. Dinner items include assorted breads, Tunisian couscous and shrimp salad, butternut squash soup, Durban chicken, and oak roast pork ribs. I'm just, Holly's like drooling right now.
Well, half of this stuff I've never heard of in my life, so I can't really drool too much because I don't know what a Durban chicken is. I picture a chicken with a little hat on or something.
It tastes like chicken.
Tastes like chicken. So, in this location, it says to inquire with your server about allergy-free options. Mm-hmm. So, last but not least, we are going to stay in the same building and head over to Jico, the cooking place. Now, this place uses vibrant spices. It has crackling wood-burning ovens. It's a boutique South African wine location that transports you to the heart of Africa. Hours here are 5 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. and meal pricing is $35 to $60 for adults. They have appetizers like fire-roasted shrimp for $22, braised wild boar tenderloin for $19, entrees such as oat-grilled filet mignon for $59, Botswana seesaw short ribs for $52, and a sustainable fish that they carry that changes from time to time for $48. There are several dinner enhancements that you can choose from to add on as well. Desserts, loose leaf teas, they specialize in kids' meals, coffees, allergy-free offerings make up a high portion of the menu. Jico is considered part of the signature dining location, so it would be 2 dining credits if you're using the dining plan.
Oh, wow.
So that one's a little pricier.
Mary, your thoughts?
What are your thoughts on this one?
Jico's really good.
Is it worth the money?
Yes, it is. We've always had excellent service there. I know 1 year my daughter got her birthday cake delivered there because we often do that. And the filet mignon is wonderful. I think Steve tried that, the short rib, and that was really good. And then the desserts are nice. And that one's pretty because it's a lot smaller than Boma. It's on the other side. Mm-hmm. And there's like water outside of the windows. You know, of course, it gets dark. But
yeah,
it's a really pretty restaurant inside. And it, like I said, it's smaller than Boma. So it's not quite as loud for dinner.
Okay.
It gets a little loud over in Boma sometimes.
Okay. All right. So now that I'm full from eating all that food, I need to go take a nap. So, Holly, tell us about the pools.
You're going to take a nap at the pool?
I'm going to take a nap right
now.
That's
a good way to get sunburned.
You eat all the food, you're going to put on a bathing suit? That sounds awful.
I'd be a little bloated, but oh well.
Okay, so Mary, if any of this is incorrect, please, because you know, Disney doesn't have the best information on their website, but I see 2 pools. Does that sound accurate? Okay.
Yes.
Okay, so there's the... I have no idea how to pronounce these. Uzima Springs Pool. And that seems to be the larger one.
Yes.
It's 230,000 gallons. It has the zero entry point, which I love those.
I love
so you're
that.
Not awkward trying to climb up and down stairs.
Oh,
better for your knees and all of that. And because this is a deluxe resort, as you know, they always have to have a water slide. So this one is a 67-foot water slide. And then this faces the Uzima Savannah. So then the other one, oh gosh, I got sloppy with my writing. Samo.
That's the Maja, isn't it?
No, it says
Samawadi, I believe.
Yeah,
Samawadi.
Yeah.
I'm so letting you guys pronounce everything.
It's the Kidani pool. Just say the Kidani pool.
So yeah, this is in the Kidani Villas. So this water slide, so is 128-foot water slide. So much larger.
Wow.
But it's 118,000 8 gallons. So about half the size, but a much larger water slide. Now, I wasn't exactly sure where this was, but the Uwanja camp. So it's like a water playground. Which pool is that at?
That's at the Kidani pool.
Okay.
That's easier to say. Okay, yeah, you can kind of see that. It's off to the side. There's like a water playground. It's
so
cute.
Those are always fun. Yeah, so that's a little like splash pad water playground. And it says there's 3 different zones for kids of all ages. Then, of course, they always have the poolside activities. You usually get a schedule for those, and they'll have different pool parties. I know one of the last times we stayed at like the Disneyland Hotel, they had a pool party, but they had all the characters out there in their little swimsuits. Wow. And that was so cute. So I know that they randomly will do that at for the pool parties and games and trivia and all of that. So there's usually something happening. So those are the pools. And then, as you said earlier, they have the poolside bars and things for your drinks and snacks.
And Holly, not to butt in, but when I was doing my research for tonight's show, I was looking at the pools going, if I was picking a Disney resort just based on the pool, this is the one.
So, yeah. So, Mary, can you tell me a little bit about the pools? Because like I said, I had to go to like TripAdvisor to try to get some better photos of the pools, because Disney, it's crazy. They only show one photo of the main pool, and then no photos of the Kidani pool.
Yeah, and see, so it's I don't know, we haven't mentioned this yet, but let's mention it, because so this resort, when you get to Jumbo, the main one, you're coming in on the third floor, so it's kind of weird, you know, because I'm constantly helping lost people when I'm there, because it's a little confusing, because you know they come in looking for the restaurants and they're downstairs. So that gets very confusing. So down, if you go in the main Jumbo, you go down, that's where Boma is and Mara, and the pool is kind of there. So you see that pool a lot more because, well, since I don't usually get a Savannah view, sometimes in the concierge room, sometimes you get a pool view, which is fine. And so you see that pool, whereas the Kidani pool is kind of like tucked away, lush greenery, and there is some shade, so it's nice. But the water slide is nice for the Jumbo pool, and I guess it's bigger for the other, but it's always been so cold when we're there.
Right.
One time I think we used the pool the first day, and then the rest of the time it was too cold. So, and that's even for like my kids. So it was pretty cold. I swear this year when we were there in January, it was the full week of Florida winter, because it was freezing the entire time.
Freezing.
And if I'm freezing, it's pretty freezing.
That's saying a lot.
But the pools are very nice. I mean, the main pool is beautiful. I mean, because like I said, I've seen it a lot from the rooms.
Holly, are both pools zero entry?
Yeah, that's what it says. So that's really, really a plus. I think most Disney pools, especially at Deluxe, I feel like they are, like thinking back, at least, you know, one side of it is. So
yeah.
And I'll
nobody wants to see this body going up and down a ladder.
Well,
nobody.
And I'll make the walk all the way around to not have to do that.
And it's also good for accessibility too.
Definitely. So in addition to the pools and all the activities there, then of course they have the Jumbo House, the campfire, which they typically have these at Disney resorts where they do roasting marshmallows. And then they do have a playground, the Hakuna Matata. Oh my gosh, I can't believe that. I couldn't say that. Playground, which is nice in idea, but typically you're either too cold, right? Or it burns your rear end. So playgrounds are a nice idea, but
they're nice for early spring.
A playground with swings and slides and that kind of thing.
Yes.
It's actually very nice there, because we have used it. It is nice. There is some shade, so
Good. Look like there was a lot of shrubbery around there, which is good.
Is there an age limit to the swings and slides?
No, there might be a weight limit, but I don't think there's an age limit.
Just don't knock any little kids over, and you're good.
Now, do they have the movies under the stars there as well?
Yes. Yeah, okay. So they have that, and then they have the dreaded arcade, which, you know, we try not to ever find that. And then they have another thing that says wild about painting. So it looks like they do like a painting class. Have you ever done any of those, Mary?
Not the painting class, but a lot of the deluxe ones have that now. Like one, they're usually a little hard because they're like one day a week at like 2 o'clock or something crazy. Mm-hmm. So
I know, I've noticed that. So yeah, so that was wild about painting. And then it said they had like a spa and fitness center, but it said it was closed. So I don't know what's going on with that. So the nearest like spa and massage facility is Grand Floridian.
You know what it seems like? A lot of these places after COVID, they did not reopen.
Yeah.
I don't really remember them ever.
You know, they're kind of gradually getting back to that, but you know, not all of them are open yet.
Yeah.
I just don't remember it ever having a spa there, but I know it had a fitness center, but
yeah, because so it said like it was connected together and it said like massage and sauna.
Okay.
So it sounds like it's very limited.
That makes sense. Okay. And then you didn't mention it, but at Kidani, and you don't have to be DVC, there's the community hall.
Okay.
And that's actually one of my most favorite community halls. A lot of the DVC resorts, let me think, Beach Club doesn't, of course. The best resort. Anyway, have a community hall. And you don't, like, people think you have to be DVC, but you don't.
Okay, and what is that?
So that's at Kidani, and it's on, when you come in, so when you come in Jumbo, you're on the third floor. When you come in Kidani, you're on the second floor.
Okay.
So let's get confused here, okay? And then it's even more confusing, because at Kidani, there's certain elevators that you can't go to the first floor where the restaurant is. So Sanaa is on the first floor.
Holy moly.
And you have to take a certain elevator. So like I said, I'm always helping lost people. Because it's a little confusing until you get the layout of it. But on the second floor, when you come in, on Kidani, not far off the lobby on the right side, right across from the laundry, it's called Community Hall. And this one is wonderful because it has sliding glass doors and the giraffes are always out there. Mm. Like, almost always. And you're actually above Sanaa, which is where they try, you know, they try to put things for the animals to come closer.
Okay, so what do you do in the Community Hall? I have no idea.
So, you know, it's kind of a joke around DVC. So, like, if you're staying in a regular Disney hotel, the rooms are ready at 3. But if you're staying in a DVC, they could be 4. And if you're like in a one bedroom with a kitchen, which has a dishwasher they got to run through and a stove they got to clean, and it's probably going to be 4 o'clock. So it's a great place to go hang out. Like, they have video games there. You could play those for free. They have like coloring sheets, which is what my kid always wants to get a ton of. They have free crafts, which are cute. Sometimes it's like that scratch. I don't know, Holly, you probably know better what it's called. Like the thing where they scratch off the.
Yeah, like scratch art.
Scratch art or something. Sometimes it's like a little bracelet kit, and then they have other crafts that you can pay for, including like ceramics. But I mean, nothing's more than like 10 bucks, 10, 15 bucks.
And that's where sometimes they do like where you can make the tie-dye shirts, I think. And I think Marla posted one time she did that, like a mosaic stone.
Yeah, that's at Coronado Springs. Oh. And that's actually up in the Dahlia.
Okay, that's what it would be like, the community room. That's those type of things in the community room.
So, I mean, there's a pool table in the Animal Kingdom Lodge one. There's a TV with a sofa, and there's even like toys for smaller kids, like the big, you know, not Legos, but they're fake Legos. And I think
so. It's basically a time killer place.
It is. And sometimes it's a good place like for downtime or something, if you know you're wait, or like your checkout day, if you have like an hour to wait for the ride or something.
But see, that is not listed when you look at amenities and recreation.
Right. And I think a lot of people think you have to be DVC to go in there, but you really don't. And it's staffed by the same people who do the pool activities. So, you know, and you can like go in there, and they're open usually until like 9-ish or so. You can go in there and get like crayons and coloring sheets and take them with you on the airplane kind of thing. They'll give you, you know, some markers. I mean, they're pretty friendly. Mm-hmm. And it's just a little fun thing for kids.
If only I'd known about that before I moved here. I'd have those coloring sheets all the time on the plane.
Oh, and they always have magnets too. They make like, they take little pictures and cut out and then glue it to magnets, and then you can pick a magnet off the board, and that's all free. So, I mean, it's a nice little perk. Something
very nice. Okay. So, Mary, I would love to hear any personal special moment things or experiences that you and your family have had staying there. Do you have anything that really comes to mind that you just think about more often than other things?
Yeah, I have a couple of things. So, of course, I had to ask Steve, what do you know? Because, like I said, we go to Animal Kingdom Lodge generally every January. Mm-hmm. What we like to do is try to get concierge for a night or two and then go to a regular DVC room for the rest of the time. Because, like, if you're going to do concierge, first of all, like, you're not really, you got to hang out there to really experience it because you want to try all the food they're putting out.
Yeah, right.
You know, you basically get, like, the breakfast is a regular plenty of food breakfast. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that was a little tough for us to get to because it ended at, like, 10 o'clock or maybe even 9:30. So I, you know, once Nevaeh got old enough, I could get her down there and get her to get everything for us. So I could, so I'd walk down, and by the time I got down there, she'd have like a little everything. It was everything.
That's funny.
But so then they have like a, they call it, I think, journey or something. So after they put the breakfast away, then they put out like snacks. You can make like a trail mix, which is kind of cool. And they have like goldfish and, potato chips and things like that. Mm-hmm. And then they'll give you water, which is nice if you're going to go to the park. But mm-hmm. I like to book that like on my travel day so that you can like hang out and experience it.
Yeah.
And then alcohol is with concierge too, which doesn't interest me, but I know that's exciting to lots of people.
And I'll take yours.
You'll take mine. And they have a lot of those African wines and everything mm-hmm. to try. So people look very happy with all that. And then in the evening, which is why I say you got to hang out there, they have like two, like basically entrees that they would usually have at Boma that mm-hmm. are, you know, you can get a little sample size of them, but you can keep mm-hmm. going back a million times and get mm-hmm. enough for dinner.
Like a
and
whole
then at like, I don't know, 7, I think, to 9 or 8 to 10, they do desserts. And
oh, okay.
There's usually some other snacks, but they kind of got to know us there. So I think a couple times we walked up and they just would go get Nevaeh like a to-go plate of food.
Yeah. Like,
you know, she'd have cheeses and the Uncrustables and they're like, well, we know she's going to want a lot. So here you go.
That's so funny.
And then they have a, they have the Mickey shaped sugars, which are adorable there. And they have an espresso machine that every year I say, I just want to go home and buy one, but it's, I've looked it up and it's quite expensive. So, but it's a very nice espresso machine that no one knows how to operate, even though it clearly tells you on the thing. So, you know,
they just put one of those in the, lounge, the DVC lounge at Disneyland. Well, not one, oh, but they put okay. two.
Okay.
So, yeah.
I love that thing.
Fun.
Very nice.
So concierge is awesome. You know, if you can ever try it, I definitely recommend it. And then, so Steve said I had to talk about the zebra domes because we went kind of over them quick at Boma. Zebra domes are awesome. And then actually, they sell them in gluten-free versions if anybody's gluten-free. And I actually wow. like the gluten-free version a little bit better.
Really?
Yes.
Interesting.
Which is crazy. And, you know, they do have a little bit of alcohol in them, but it you know, it yeah. cooked off a little bit. And you
it's
can now get
off.
Them.
It's cooked off.
It's cooked off. So you can actually get them. It didn't used to be. You could only get them at the buffet, but then they put them in the Mara, and they also have them in the Kidani gift shop because there's the big gift
those
shop.
Those are the chocolate mousse, right? Is that?
Yeah, they're like okay, little domes.
Yeah,
with
domes.
Black and white chocolate. Mm-hmm. So we didn't really talk about the gift shops either. So the main Jumbo has the big gift shop, I call it. I mean, it's not huge, but it's a good-sized gift shop with like a little bit of everything, Disney merchandise. Mm-hmm. The Kidani gift shop is a lot smaller. It has some DVC merchandise pins, and that's where you would get your like drink cup refilled if you don't want to okay. go, you know, because mm-hmm. there's no other place to use your drink cup during like other hours unless you go all the way to the other building, which is
yeah.
You know. And there is a shuttle. We didn't talk about that. Jay didn't okay. talk. There is a shuttle between the two sides of mm-hmm. Jumbo and Kidani.
Oh, that's good to know. Okay.
If you don't want to walk, and it's like a little one of those little small bus, and I mean it's there's one constantly, so you're not waiting mm-hmm. a real long time. So if you want
so
to go,
how long is the walk from one to the other?
It's a little long. I mean, it's like minutes? 10 to 15 minutes.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, you know, it's not terrible, but after you walked around a park all day, it's
yeah
it's a little,
yeah.
And then it also depends on where your room is too. Mm-hmm. You know, because you can, there is a way to cut through and you're not outside real long if it's cold and you can mm-hmm. get in sooner and then go down the hallways, mm-hmm. you know, if you want. But it can be a little long after a long day in the park.
Okay.
Let's see.
Very interesting. I like that.
Oh, and then Boma. I have to talk about this at Boma because he also wanted me to talk about this. I'm not a big bread pudding fan, but at Boma for breakfast, they have this bread pudding and they have warm caramel and then they have warm vanilla sauce to put on it. And it is the most delicious thing ever.
That sounds good.
Wow.
And like I said, I think that's the best.
Go over there and get some.
I'm like, I'm 20 minutes away. I'll be right back, ladies.
Go get that wine flight and go get some bread pudding.
Yeah.
Go.
Okay. So Mary, why do you stay? I know that you're a creature of habit and you basically yes. do the same thing every January and every September. But so why do you choose to stay there? Is it because you can get concierge for less points than another location, or you just really love African feel?
So that's the only concierge that DVC can book, which is
okay.
So like there's other concierge, but you know, you have to pay a lot of money for that. And so I want to say, I mean, the points there are so cheap. I want to say they're like only 29 points or something for a studio for concierge, which is really not bad. Mm-hmm. It's just they're really hard to get. So like I sign on at the 11-month window and try to get that immediately. A lot of times you just get on the wait list and then you hope it comes through. Actually, this was the first January that it didn't come through in like 5 years.
I remember, yeah.
Mm-hmm. But we did get it for February before our cruise. So that was pretty cool. I booked it, got on the wait list, and then like a week later I got it. So it was like, okay. Because, you know, it's just hard. There's only 15 rooms. So that's part of it. And then it's just different. I mean, yes, you're a little far from places, but it's a beautiful resort. And you could just walk around there and look at, there's artwork and all sorts of things. And now the cultural representatives are back. So they're in the lobby telling you things and, you know, doing information on the art. So it's just a different experience, I guess.
I love the fact that those people are there and they
can that's really
any information that you want to know about anything there. I think that's awesome. Not all resorts have that, you know.
Yeah.
Right.
I kind of wish that Wilderness Lodge would have somebody there, because there are artifacts around there mm-hmm. that I would want to, besides the little plaque that's sitting there, that I would want to know about.
Right.
So
in the main, in Jumbo, now the Kidani lobby is a lot smaller. I mean, it's still beautiful, but the Jumbo lobby has the fire pit. And then it has, and I should know the name of it because I look at it every year. It is this like thing, and you don't really know what it is until you go up to it and start reading the plaques around it. It's actually a headdress. So I don't know if anybody's been there, but I mean, it's a huge thing and there's a whole story in around it, and like how the person in the village is honored and gets to they have to carry this thing. It's huge.
Oh,
and
wow.
So it's definitely worth reading about that. Cause you know, I mean, I'm kind of used to it, so I go past it, but I read about it many years, and anytime I take mm-hmm. it, I'm like, you gotta go read about that, you know, cause it's a cool story. And there's just a lot of nice, interesting artwork that you should go around and read the little plaques about and check it out. And then at night you can borrow the goggles to see the animals.
Oh yeah.
And do the tour. You know, there's other tours you can sign up for where they'll take you out mm-hmm. and everything. Mm-hmm. Did you do one of those, Holly, or you were going to do one, or were you looking at one? I don't. I thought we talked about it at one point.
But yeah, but I feel like they didn't have it or something.
That might've been.
Yeah.
Maybe.
But that does sound familiar.
Because I need to look and see if they're offering again. But before COVID, they had a food tour, which was really good, where you met at GECO, like at an odd time, like 2 o'clock or something in the middle of the day. And they took you in and told you things about GECO that you got to taste something. And then you actually went to Boma too. Before, it was all right before it opened, you know, for the dinner service. And
that's
it was like
cool.
Free. Yeah. I mean, and it was really cool.
Wow. That's awesome.
I know they do like kids cookie decorating usually right before the restaurants open too, and that's free. So I mean, there's a lot to do there. I know it is a little bit further away, but it's definitely worth staying
for
there.
Me, yeah. The resorts, they have a lot of things, and it's not even Disney. It's a lot of resorts that we go to, but you don't find out about, like, it's hard to get all the information and when and where, and people just don't know. And I wish that they would tell you at check-in, like give you the long list of everything. Cause a lot of times it's like, as you're checking out, like they'll give you the survey. Did you do this, this, and this? And you're like, what the heck was that? I didn't know what this was. And it's not Disney. It's every resort. Even when we just stayed at our timeshare recently, they had stuff I had no idea that they offered until it was checked out.
I just find it very convenient. They go, oh, by the way, on your way out, you forgot this stuff. Come back.
Yeah. Well, yeah. I know.
Well, especially now when you're doing online check-in, you don't even get, you know, I never go to the desk.
Right. Exactly.
That's why people need to listen to our Detour for resort, because you find out all of this very valuable information. Thank you. Back to the scheduled program.
And there is, so if you want to see all the things that are available, because I see it all the time, because it's right by the nice bathroom. It's right off the lobby. There's like a case and it has what's going on there, and it does change monthly, like the times a little bit. But there's a lot, because like there's, you can go talk to all the cultural representatives. So they set up like a table generally, and it'll be like, I don't know, they're showing you something about turtles, or because there's big turtles outside of Banas, especially. And after you participate in that, and it's not, it's mostly kids, but they're, it's educational. They give them like a little bead to make their bracelet that you start when you get there. And so, and I do see people telling them about that, but you know, everybody's rushing to the park.
Exactly. Yeah.
Very nice. Well, Mary, thank you so much for being with us for this adventure tonight. And we really appreciate all of your input that you were able to offer us. Holly and Jay, any final thoughts on this resort?
I need to go back, because we were only there for a short time, a couple hours, and we didn't experience any of the restaurants. And they were doing a lot of construction. So I was honestly very unimpressed, because everything was covered in scaffolding and I don't know. So
I did get to see it another shot.
We went at Christmas time, so I did see some of the beautiful trees, which was nice. But it's not the same when you walk in and everything's covered with tarps and things. So I definitely need to go back, and I have to get that bread service at some point in my life. So,
Jay, how about you?
I'm going to end it with bus.
Passengers, have you stayed at Animal Kingdom Lodge before, or is this one of the resorts on your bucket list? As it is mine, I really have had this on my list for the longest time, and for some reason I just keep putting it off, and I really don't know why. So let us know in the comments section. And since Ken told us some stuff about MEI, he's going to take it away for us right now.
The Grand Circle Tour podcast is brought to you in part by Expedition Roasters. When you visit expeditionroasters.com, use the promo code Grand Circle Tour Podcast, that's all one word, and you will receive 10% off of your purchase. If you would like to keep the adventure going after the show, be sure to visit our Facebook page, Disney Friends of the Grand Circle Tour Podcast. While you're on Facebook, like our page, Grand Circle Tour Podcast. Be sure to follow us on Twitter, Grand Circle Tour Podcast, on Instagram at GCT Podcast, and our YouTube channel, Grand Circle Tour. On TikTok, Grand Circle Tour. That's all one word. If you'd like to email us, drop us a line, gctpodcast@gmail.com. T-shirts and other fun merch can be found at tpublic.com. Simply search Grand Circle Tour Podcast. If you enjoyed your visit, leave us a review on Apple Podcasts. Only one rule, make it good. All logos, sounds, music, and songs that are made by and for Disney and its affiliates are owned in full by the Disney Corporation, and they are not, nor are they intended to be owned in any way by the Grand Circle Tour Podcast. Thank you for riding with us, and welcome home.
Please exit to your left by stepping away from the cars with your left foot first. Step out and stand on the moving platform, please.
Please exit by stepping away from the cars with your left foot first. Step out and stand on the moving platform, please.